Okay, so today we are going to do the poem Light Shining Out of Darkness by William Cowper. Now, William Cowper, you know, it is also called the transition age where, see, first it was the 18th century where we were having neoclassical poets, okay? And then in the 19th century we have the romantic poets, romanticism. Now, this transition, this change from romanticism, from the neoclassical to romanticism, this change period is called the Augustan age. It's a transitional period. It's a change. Transition means change. So it's a transitional period and it is called the Augustan age. And William Cowper is one of the leading poets of the transition age or the Augustan age. Now, William Cowper, he lost his mother at a very early age. Okay, so we have one of his poems which is dedicated to his mother also. So, he lost his mother at a very early age, so therefore, and he had many hardships in his life. He suffered many problems in his life and to the extent that he even tried to commit, suicide. But, in the end, he realized that this life which is given to us, this life is a very, very kind of very precious life. It is given to us by God. And therefore, he started writing hymns. Hymns ka matlab bhent, aarti, for God. And Light Shining Out of Darkness is one of the hymns which is sung in the Methodist. Methodist is, you know, kind of a part of Christianity. Catholic, Protestants, Methodist, they are all parts of the religion. And they started singing this hymn written by William Cowper in the church. So now, Light Shining Out of Darkness is also one of the hymns which is written by William Cowper. And it is a beautiful hymn where the poet says that we are human beings and therefore our power of thinking, our power of judging, our power of understanding God is very, very limited. Very limited. See, it is as limited as our eyesight. When we look at this room, you know, when you're looking at me, you can see me and you can see the wall. Can you see beyond the wall? No. This is the restriction of our eyesight. Similarly, he says, how God works, what God thinks, what God plans for us, we do not know. And therefore, we should not judge God. We should blindly believe, have faith and, you know, have belief in God that whatever God is doing, He's doing for our best, for our good. He's not doing anything to harm us or to punish us. And when you understand this, then you will have full faith in God. So he says God moves in a mysterious way. Moves means God works, God plans. In a mysterious way. Mysterious means unknown, which is not known to us. God works or God plans or God executes His plans or God, you know, thinks about us in a way which we do not know. Only God knows what He has thought for us. It's mysterious. He His wonders to perform, He plants His footsteps in the sea and rides upon the storm. He moves in a mysterious way, His wonders. There are many miracles which God performs. But we do not know how these miracles work. Hame nahi maloom ki ye chamatkar kaise hote hain. Whatever He does it on His own. He does not share His plan with us. He does not share what He has thought about us. He plants His footsteps in the sea. He can do anything. God is omnipotent, all-powerful. He can do anything. He can plant His footsteps in the sea. The sea is made of what? Water. Can you leave your marks or footsteps on the water? No. But God can. So He plants His footsteps in the sea means He leaves His mark. He leaves His example of power even on the sea. And He rides upon the storms and He has the power to control the storms. So everything which is happening in this world, the sea is moving, the plants are growing, the flowers are blooming, the storms are coming, there is lightning, there is rainfall, there is sunshine. Everything is performed by God. And how He does it, we do not know. Deep in unfathomable minds of never failing skills, God can work anywhere. God has His power upon the sea. God has His power deep in the minds. Minds means khane. And they are very, very deep. Unfathomable ka matlab, which cannot be measured. The depth which cannot be measured is unfathomable. So God can go very deep, even in immeasurable minds, and His skill. Skill means His perfectness, His way of working, His actions are absolutely never failing. Kamatab, they do not have any kind of mistake. God works in such a perfect way that He does not make any mistake. He treasures up His breath, designs and works His sovereign will. He treasures means He hides. So this is a metaphor. Just as you know, you have treasures, you have money, you have valuable things. What do? You guard it. You treasure it. Okay? And similarly, you hide it from the people. Similarly, God also treasures means hides His plans, His will, His wish, His actions. Bhagwan kabhi kisi ko nahi batata unhone kya socha hai. He treasures up His bright designs. Bright means which are helpful for the mankind. Design means plan, and plan which is put into action. So God hides His never failing perfect plans, and He works His sovereign will, and God works according to His own wish. Sovereign means supreme. It is not under anybody. Nobody can guide, nobody can instruct God how to work. He works according to His own wish, He works according to His own plans, according to His own designs. His wish, will means wish, His plan is supreme. Nobody can tell Him how to work. E, fearful saints. E means you, fearful saints. Fearful, we are scared of God. We are afraid of God. But we say God. But if He says that if you are saint, saint means if you are good people, you are virtuous people, you are pious, you do not harm anybody, you should not be fearful from God. E, fearful saints, fresh courage take. Have courage. Courage means saas. Have belief. Have courage in God. If you are good, if you are virtuous, you should not fear God. Fir hame darne ki zarurat hi nahi hai. There is no need to fear God. The clouds he so much dread are big with mercy. So this is a metaphor. Clouds here denote sorrow. Clouds here denote depression. It denotes dejection. It denotes sorrow. So he says, the clouds which you so much dread. Dread means you are fearful, you are afraid of. You are afraid of the sorrow, you are afraid of the problems, you are afraid of the tensions, you are afraid of the dejection and depression and grief. He says, these clouds, you think that they are clouds. But what do they have? They have water in them. The clouds, they... The clouds, what happened is, what do? They are full of rain. Badal kya hote hain? They are full of rain. And rain is again, it is, mercy means, rain means mercy. So this is again a metaphor. So the clouds are compared to sorrow, the clouds are compared to problems and tensions which we are dreading. But actually, these clouds are full of mercy, full of love of God. So what happens is that initially, primarily, on the first stage we think that God has not done good for us. Okay, God is giving us so many problems, God is giving us so many tensions. But it is at the end, we realize that whatever God thought for us was good. Kehte na, Bhagwan jo karta hai,
अच्छा करता है
एंड इट शैल ब्रेक इन ब्लेसिंग्स ऑन योर हेड. सो दीज प्रॉब्लम दीज टेंशन दीज डिजेक्शन एंड डिप्रेशन एंड सॉरो विच लुक वेरी ग्लूमी विच लुक वेरी सॉरोफुल ऑन द सुपरफिशियल लेवल प्राइमरीली at the starting, at the beginning they look very very gloomy, very very sorrowful, but actually they are blessings in disguise. Blessing ka matlab bhagwan ka aashirwad in disguise. Disguise means hidden. It is not clear. First we think it is sorrow, but in the end we realize it was not sorrow, actually it was a blessing of God for us. Judge not the Lord by feeble sense. The poet says we should not judge God, whether God is right or whether God is wrong, whether God is good or whether God is bad, whether God is merciful or he is cruel. We do not have the power to judge God. He says, judge not the Lord by feeble sense. Feeble means weak. Sense means our power of thinking, intelligence. Our intelligence, our power of thinking is not so strong that we can judge God. We are very ignorant. We are very foolish. We do not have the intelligence to judge God. हम भगवान के बारे में कोई निर्णय या कोई जो राय जो है वो नहीं बना सकते. But trust him for his grace. You can do only one thing. You have to trust God. You have to believe in God. You have to have faith in God for his grace. Grace means mercy. He is merciful. Lord is merciful. God is merciful. God is full of love for us. God is full of grace for us. We should have full faith about God. Behind a frowning providence, he hides a smiling face. On the superficial level, we feel God is angry with us. Frowning means angry. Providence means face. So when the problems, when the tensions, when the sorrow comes to us, we feel as if God is angry with us. He's punishing us for something. Okay? कहते हैं भगवान हमसे नाराज है, भगवान हमसे रूठ गया है. But behind a angry face, he has a smiling face. Because God knows what he has planned for you. And he knows very well that whatever he has planned for you is going to be good for you. So, he has a smiling face. Smiling face means a face full of mercy, full of love. So, initially we feel God is angry with us. But in the end, we realize that whatever God has done very good for us. His purposes will ripen fast. Purpose means his intentions. God's intentions, God's plans, God's whatever he has thought for us, it will ripen means it will open fast. Very soon we will come to know what God has planned for us. Unfolding every hour. Unfolding means revealing, opening. We will come to know what God has thought for us. Every hour means very soon. जो भी भगवान ने हमारे लिए सोचा है हमें बहुत जल्दी मालूम पड़ जाएगा क्या सोचा है. The bud may have a bitter taste, but sweet will be the flower. So it is the most beautiful line. The bud means kali. So if you taste the bud, it is bitter in taste. But when it becomes a flower, it becomes very sweet. So initially we feel that whatever God has thought for us, whatever God's intentions are, they are very harmful for us. But in the end we realize, no, whatever God thought for us was very good for us. So this is what? This is again a metaphor. Where God's hidden plans are just like buds. So just as the bud is bitter, the hidden plan of God, initially we feel that whatever God has thought for us is not good. But just as the flower is sweet, similarly when the plants, they are open in front of us, we feel, okay, whatever God does to us is very good for us, beneficial. Blind unbelief is sure to err and scan his work in vain. Blind unbelief. Do not lose belief. Do not lose faith in God. Otherwise, you are surely going to err. Err means make mistake, make error. If you don't believe in God, if you lose faith in God, if you lose belief in God, you will surely make mistake. And scan his work in vain. Scan means do not try to judge, analyze, examine his work, because it will be in vain. Vain means useless, worthless. Don't try to judge God. Don't try to analyze what he has done. Don't try to examine what he has done. It is useless, it is worthless, you will not understand. Just have belief that God, whatever he is doing, it is doing for our own benefit. God is his own interpreter. Interpreter means who can analyze. Interpreter means who can understand. Interpreter means who can scan and examine. God alone can examine. God alone can analyze. God alone can understand what he has planned for you. You will not be able to understand. And he will make it plain. Plain means open, reveal. And soon he will reveal, he will open, he will tell you what he has planned for you. So don't try to judge the work of God.